in Section 375. I have been exploited. Women are vulnerable at the workplace because they are being exploited. They are being harassed. I have seen it happening in front of my eyes. I always wanted to go to Hollywood. So I work like a Hollywood writer or director works. They put in a lot of research. They are systematic in their work. And they put a lot of hard work into writing a script, which I have done. Writers in India do superficial kind of work. Even if it is a true story, you'll see 5 songs in the movie. The creative liberties are too many. And even if the movie is based on a real character or on a true incident, you know this, the real character could have never done this. So they don't rely on research. They use what I would call filmy creative liberties. Okay, that's why you don't find the movie so authentic. What I've done is I've kept it very real. I wrote the script describing exactly how a trial court works because I've been in 160 hearings. So I described it exactly how a court works in the real manner. And how do real people react? That's why you see a sense of realism. That's why it's being hailed as the best courtroom drama, because of the research, because of the hard work that has gone into it. And also the movie avoids any cliches. There are a lot of cliches in Hindi movies. So I've avoided all cliches. Plus, I have written this film repeatedly. I wrote 29 drafts of it. 29 drafts over 3 years. So I wrote it again, again and again till I was satisfied that it's really working very well now. Because I couldn't have gone wrong with this. Because had I gone wrong with this, in today's age, feminists would have torn me apart. I would have been labeled as a misogynist. So I had to be very careful. And I was dealing with a very sensitive issue. It's a very, very sensitive issue. It's an issue which is very relevant to our country today. I couldn't have gone wrong. I had to get it right. I had to strike a balance. I had to show a very unbiased view of this law. And there are two point of views, there are two perspectives. So I had to do equal justice to both perspectives. So the movie, in effect, what it's trying to say is, while rape is a heinous crime and rape is rampant in India and the conviction rate is sadly very, very low, but at the same time, there are fake rape cases happening. The worst part of this is these fake rape cases further damage the prospects of a genuine rape survivor. Because her statement comes under doubt because of that. So, women are the worst affected by fake rape cases. So, that is what the film is trying to say. For Section, I think the best compliments I've ever received is for Section 375. Because Twitter is going ballistic. People are saying it's the best courtroom drama ever made in India. And surprisingly, I think this is the first time in the history of Indian cinema that the writer is getting so much of mileage. So people are praising the actors and the writing. So the script and the dialogues and the story, the plot, the screenplay, they are being praised so much. Some people have also said this is even better than a Hollywood movie. What could be a better compliment? And it's called the best courtroom drama ever made in India. There can be no compliment better than this. Except for the judiciary, nobody has the right to pass a judgment on anybody. Neither any filmmaker or actor or producer or the media. We do not have the right to pass a judgment on anybody or to say that I do not want to work with this person because he's been accused. The judiciary will decide whether the man is guilty or not. And if the man is proven guilty by a court of law, by all means you should not work with him. You should stop associating with him. But till the man is proven guilty by a court, how can he be subjected to, you know, being ostracized? That's not fair. That makes any man vulnerable. Any woman can just accuse him and then put him out of business, ruin his life. So that makes a man completely vulnerable. So that is not exactly what we want. Our society will erupt into chaos if that happens. At the same time, women need to be protected. Women are vulnerable at the workplace because they are being exploited. They are being harassed. I have seen it happening in front of my eyes. Now, how do you do this? You do this only if there's a structure. There's a structure where the man knows that I can't do this and get away with it. And the woman knows that I can't file a fake complaint and get away with it. Then the balance will happen and then men and women will be safe alike. The Me Too movement is absolutely needed. I look at the Me Too movement not as a gender biased movement. I'm glad that there's a Men Too movement also now. So the Me Too movement, Men Too movement, they should be combined into one. As I look at it, the Me Too movement is not about gender bias. Me Too movement is about the abuse of power. A person in a superior position of power, abusing a person, using a person, exploiting a person who is in a inferior position of power. It has happened to me. It has happened to me several times. When a person more powerful than me has exploited me. Of course, it may not have been in a sexual context, but it's still the same. It is a person exerting his power on the weaker person, and the weaker person is not in a position to fight back. Okay, so I have experienced it firsthand several times. I would also say I have experienced it in this film, in Section 375. I have been exploited. I do not want to elaborate on it at this point in time. So I really respect the Me Too movement, but there's another side to it. The Me Too movement opens men in general to a sort of vulnerability. Like, every man is now vulnerable. So for example, if there's a man in the office and a girl has some sort of grouse against him, he's done something, he scolded her, or he, you know, swore at her or something like that, she can just say, oh, he harassed me, and that man is thrown out of the office. So it's become very random. The Me Too movement is required. It's absolutely required, but there has to be a system in place. It should not be so easy as to, on the basis of an allegation, the man is sacked and punished. It should not be so ad hoc or random. There has to be a system in place where the woman can lodge a complaint. Then there will be an inquiry, an investigation, and then there's some sort of punishment if it's proven true. But what happened in the movement, it was random. There were so many women accusing different people, and there were a lot of fake complaints in that. I clearly remember writer Varun Grover was accused fakely. It was proven that he was accused fakely. Actor Sushant Singh Rajput was accused fakely. Similarly, anybody can be accused. What does it take for some girl to just put on Twitter that this guy harassed me? So it was very random. So it's, while I think it's needed, there has to be a structure to it, which wasn't there. So it should be brought in. Hi, this is writer-director Manish Gupta, and you're watching me on midday.com.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.